Hello and greetings from the ISSF Grand Prix here in Ruše, Slovenia, sports hall of Janko Glazer. We're here for the 10-meter air rifle men event. Just half an hour ago, we finished with the 10-meter air rifle women. And this is the second day of competition. It's the last final of the day.
Athletes to the line.
3 days of finals. This is the last day. 19 countries competing in the ISSF Grand Prix 2022, starting with the new Olympic cycle and the new rules, of course. You see here in the finals. This is definitely a ship. First one to come to stage one, Miran Maricic from Croatia. He had a very successful year, 2021. Next up to come on to the finals, Hungarian Zalán Pekler. Shock, his coach. The second Croatian in the competition in the finals, Petr Gorša. And Siniša Vitez as his coach.
Firing point E, representing Russia, Vladimir Maslenko.
And last but not least is the Russian representative coming on for part one of stage one, Vladimir Maslenikov.
I still owe you the coaches. For Gorša is Siniša Vitez and for Maslenikov, Sergei Kruglov.
Sergei Kruglov as the coach. And you remember, in charge of the finals is Arka Binder from Serbia. And of course, the chief range officer is Robert Ferenczak.
Take your positions.
The athletes are just now going to prepare for the finals, prepare with 5 minutes of sighting time. Miran Maricic on firing point C, currently world ranking, holding 11th place for the 10-meter air rifle and placing 10th in the world 50-meter three-position man. Vladimir Maslenikov, the 27-year-old, currently ranking as fourth for the 10-meter air rifle. Bronze medalist from the Olympic Games in Rio 2016. So we have Petr Gorša here.
You'll be the same loud also now in this men final.
He started competing in 1997, currently ranking as 10th for the 10-meter. Air rifle,
from Croatia,
but
in this final.
He
can
is.
Can I hear you, some fans from Croatia? Are you here?
Ranking 8th for the 50-meter three position.
Are there some fans from Hungary?
And also, he placed 5th last year at the Tokyo Olympics.
And from Russia. Yeah! Also doing a great job.
Rifle three position.
Should we give Croatia one more try? So the fans from and Croatia get to be louder than Hungary and Russia!
Zoran Beklet.
Okay. But still bronze medal for Croatia.
A 21-year-old who practiced, started practicing shooting since 2009, currently holding 18th position for the 10-meter air rifle. He was also at the Olympics, placing 39th last year in Tokyo for the 10-meter air rifle, but he was 18th for the 50-meter. Starting with the stage one, the athletes are first to shoot 10 single shots. After each shot, they will be awarded points according to the result of the shot in each round. So the best shot wins 4 points, second best 3 points, third best 2 points, and the last or the least shot is to win 1 point in each round. After 10 shots, one of the athletes leaving the finals, and the three athletes remaining will continue with another 5 shots, where the best shot wins 3 points, second best 2, and the lowest shot wins 1 point. This is the rifle. Maximum weight of the rifle is 5.5 kilograms. This is what they're all shooting with, but this is not the only part of the equipment for rifle shooters. It's really, really important to have a good equipment, meaning the jacket and the shoes and the shooting pants that they use, with exact measurements that they're permitted for the equipment, regulations in literally millimeters. And this shows what a technical discipline this is, and the shooters have to be very much aware of it. It's not just the training and the shooting, it's also being very familiar with their equipment, and they have to be skilled to work with the equipment.
30 seconds.
That's much different than what we experience with the pistol shooters. So the athletes usually either shoot pistol or rifle, depending on what they decided on in the beginning of their career, or maybe even later changing it. But rarely do any athletes shoot both pistol and rifle. The 5 minutes of sighting time is finished now. And we are just about to begin with the first shot.
For the first competition,
10 single shots that we'll be seeing here.
Start.
Aslanikov. Beklet already shot 18.7. We see Maslenikov. Maslenikov here with a 10.3. Maricic 10.4 and Gorsha 10.0 in this round. Beklet was the first one to shoot, and he is the one with the highest score of 10.7, winning the 4 points.
For the next competition,
Maricic with the 10.4 wins 3 points. Maslenikov 2 points, and Gorsha winning the 1 point in first round. Beckler. .5. All right, in the last finals that we were seeing for the air rifle women, Arsovic was really quick on the trigger. She was the first one to shoot. And it looks like in this round, this is going to be Beckler. Maricic and Gorsha both had a 10.6, which means they will both earn 4 points in this round. Beckler with his 10.5, earning 2 points. And with a 10.4, Maslenikov
for the next competition,
1 point.
Load.
Here we have Maricic and Gorsha.
Start.
Beckler shooting first, 10.2. Maricic, 10.7. And Gorsha, a 10.1. Maslenikov, 10.5.
So
Maricic was the best one in this round, earning 4 points with his 10.7.
11 points in total.
10.5 by Maslenikov, earning him at 3 points, coming to a total of 6, and tying with Gorsha. Maricic is in the lead currently after 3 shots with 11 points. It's a really good score. .9, Beckler. Maricic, 10.6, Gorsha, 10.0, Maslenikov, 10.6. Tying with Maricic, each winning 4 points. Maricic is really on the roll here, coming to a total of 15 points. Strong lead for him. Maslenikov, second with 10 points. Then Beckler with 9, and Gorsha currently in fourth place with 8 points. Maricic actually started shooting and was inspired by Gorsha, and now they're together in the finals. Beckler 10.4, but he was not pleased with the score. Maricic 10.6, Maslenikov 10.8 this time. Gorsha and Maricic are tied. 3 points in the round. Maslenikov 4. And Beckler with the 10.4 that he was not so pleased with. Wins 1 point. Maricic in a good lead with a total of 18 points. Maslenikov 14. Then Gorsha with 11, and Beckler currently in the fourth place with 10 points. Gorsha and Maslenikov. Gorsha 10.5. Maricic had a 10.6. If Maslenikov doesn't go over that, and he does with the 10.7, 0.1 of the difference, bringing himself 4 points to a total of 18 now. Maricic 21. Gorsha has a total of 13, and Beckler still in the fourth place with 11 points. It's amazing what these athletes do. It's really amazing what these shooters do with the rifles. The size of the 10 is almost like a dot on a paper from a pen. So hitting that 10.9 is really no joke. Gorsha shot 10.5. Maricic 10.8. Excellent shot.
Miran Maricic.
Masnikov 10.6.
That's 4 points for him.
Maricic keeping the lead strongly with 25 points total now. Masnikov 21. Gorsha 15. And Bekler 12. We are on the eighth shot now. Maricic.
Start.
Very calm, focused in this finals. As he is in his career as well. Bekler shooting first, 10.7. Maricic. Nine. No reaction. Or at least a very, very small reaction. Masnikov 10.6, Gorsha 10.7. This was Bekler's round, winning himself 4 points, coming to a total of 16. He is coming closer to Gorsha, who has a total of 17. Masnikov also coming closer to Maricic with a total of 24. That was Bekler with a 10.4. Maricic 10.5 and Gorsha 10.5 as well. They're tied here. It just depends on Masnikov and how the points will be awarded. Masnikov 10.7, 4 points to Masnikov, 3 points to both Maricic and Gorsha. Bekler is staying behind, winning 1 point in this round, coming to a total of 17. Masnikov came very close to Maricic now. This is the last round before one of them leaves stage one without qualifying for the finals. Bekler 10.2, and it looks like it's probably going to be Bekler 10.3, Gorsha, yeah, Maricic 10.4, and Masnikov 10.5. We really have it all. 10.2, 0.3, 0.4, and 0.5. And unfortunately, it was not enough for Bekler to stay in the finals, winning the fourth place in this stage one of the finals. And now we have Maricic and Masnikov in the lead, sharing the first position with a total of 32 points.
For the next competition shot,
Gorsha is in the third place with 22 total points. It's not really looking good for him. Not an easy task to qualify for the finals, but we have 5 more shots to go for the decision. Gorsha starting with a 10.7, 10.3 Maricic, and Masnikov 10.3, tying with Maricic, both winning 2 points. Gorsha 3 points. Coming to a total of 25, he is 9 points behind both Maricic and Masnikov, who were already tied, and now hitting a 10.3, both of them just keeping the tie. Maricic and Masnikov Porsche shot a 10.8. Really good shot. 10.6 for Maricic. Masnikov winning 1 point with his 10.5. Masnikov came to a total of 35. Maricic 36 and Gorsha. Has 28 points, 7 points behind Masnikov. 3 more shots to go. It's a very, very hard task. Gorsha 10.5. Maricic a 10.9. Perfect. He already had a 10.8. Just a few shots ago. Masnikov 10.7. And like this is the end for Gorsha. There's no more way that he comes close to qualifying Gorsha for the second stage. And this is going to be it. This is going to be it for stage one. Unfortunately, Gorsha was not able to qualify for the finals, but the second Croatian representative, Miran Maricic, ending with a 10.9, is the one to go into stage two to fight for gold and alongside the Russian representative, Vladimir Masnikov, as well. So we have them already decided, Miran Maricic and Vladimir Masnikov in the finals. And we're gonna see in the second part of stage one will be the other two alongside Masnikov here and Maricic to fight for gold to win it here at the ISSF Grand Prix for the 10 meter air rifle men event in Roše, Slovenia. Stay with us. We will be back very, very shortly.
Range is cleared. Hand please to the line.
ISSF Grand Prix Russia 2022. This is the second final stage 1 10-meter air rifle man.
All right, we're back with the second part of stage one here for the 10-meter air rifle men. There's already two of them, two of the athletes qualified for the finals for the stage two. And this part will decide who will be the other two competing for gold. Istvan Penny is the Hungarian representative on firing point C, the 24-year-old currently ranking as second for the 10-meter air rifle men in the world. Next up from Czech Republic, Aleš Šentrihel. Six-year-old started competing back in 2008. Now in the finals for ISSF Grand Prix in Roše, Slovenia. From Austria, Martin Jempel. And the coach Melmer from Austria as well. Currently ranking 21st in the world ranking. And the last one to come. He is the Slovakian representative. Patrick Jani has been in many, many finals so far. Zoltan Balas, the coach. The jury member in charge, Aranka Binder. And chief range officer, Robert Ferenczak. The coaches are helping out with the rifles. To start with the 5-minute preparation sighting time that they have. Two of these are going into second stage to compete for gold against Miran Maricic from Croatia and Vladimir Maslenikov from Russia. We have a Slovakian representative, Austrian, Hungarian, and a representative from Czech Republic. And
5 minutes preparation and sighting time.
The preparation is just about to start. Time. 5 minutes. To go. While they're shooting the sighting shots and preparing for the finals, there's a explanation of what goes on. Small clip.
We are also happy to welcome here in the final hall, Mayor of Russia.
If you've been watching the finals with us all day, you've already seen what these athletes have to know and be aware of and go through every single day in training, putting on all of this equipment that's really hard in the summer, especially. It was always the paper targets in the beginning of the shooting, and they're still used in many, many of the local shooting ranges. But when we come to the big competitions like this one, it's the laser targets that are in use. We had the electronic targets for many, many years, but now these are the newest ones that are very, very precise. And it's what we use in all of the competitions. Kind of feels like they're glowing in a way. It's the best technology so far. And it's really important to develop and expand these technologies, because it's all the time put to test and the results are getting higher and higher as the athletes are learning better and developing through using the equipment optimally. Always trying to be the best that they can, which for the rifle it means that the equipment really has to be spot on for the shooter to be able to get better and expand throughout their career. As we had in the first part of the first stage, the athletes will be shooting 10 single shots. After each shot, they'll be given the points according to the score that they had in that round. So it's basically each round for itself. The best valued shot wins 4 points in the first 10 series, in the first 10 shots. Second best, 3 points. Third best, 2. And the lowest one, 1 point. In the case of an equal result, both of the athletes win the higher valued point. After the 10 single shots, one of the athletes is leaving the competition, leaving the finals, without qualifying for the second stage of the finals. After that, when there are 3 athletes, they're going to be shooting another 5 single shots. After each single shot, the best valued score is to win 3 points, second best 2, and the lowest one wins 1 point. And after the 15 shots, one more athlete is leaving the finals, and the 2 remaining are qualifying for the second stage of the finals to shoot and compete for gold alongside Miran Maricic from Croatia and Vladimir Masenikov from Russia. I think we're ready to begin and to see this decision being made. All right, first one to shoot, Penier, 10.9. That's a really nice start.
Perfect start for Ishvan Penier,
really nice.
10.9.
Way to start with the finals. Of course, the 4 points go to Penny for his 10.9. Yanni winning 3 points with the 10.7. And 2 points went to Entrichel. Stempel gets 1 point in this round.